Welcome to Railways HMIS training videos. In this video, we are going to explain about teleconsultation app for patients. This video covers two aspects. In the first part, we will explain about the installation of the app and the registration. In the second part, we will explain about the teleconsultation process in the mobile app. In the first part, we will cover following five topics. 1. How to search and install the app from App Store. 2. How to register in the app. 3. How to log in the app. 4. How to switch from one user to another user in the app. 5. How to exit and log out from the app. We will explain part 1 in 5 simple steps. Step 1. Open the App Store either on Android platform or iOS platform and search the app name as M Consultancy Railway HMIS app, and then after selecting the correct app with correct name and logo, please download and install the app. While installing the app, please accord all permissions from the phone for accessing to camera, files, microphone, etc. to facilitate the video calling and downloading documents. In addition, please allow the setting for displaying the app over other apps so that notifications of alert messages, video call, etc. will appear on the phone without restrictions. Step 2. Please enter mobile number and click on login as patient. OTP will come on the registered mobile number attached to the CR number or UMID number. Enter OTP for completion of registration. Registration will be based on CR number, which is generated when a patient with UMID number goes to railway hospital and registers for the first time in HMIS. The CR number is a permanent ID in HMIS, and if CR number is not generated so far, the same needs to be generated with UMID number through HMIS helpdesk personnel. Step 4 is about selecting the specific user or switching from one user to another user. All the accounts attached to common mobile number within the family can be seen listed in the app. And if any family member like children whose mobile number is not available, then their cases also can be seen in the login account of primary card holder, which is employee or pensioner. User can choose a specific beneficiary for raising the request for teleconsultation. For switching from one beneficiary to another, user needs to click on Switch Patient option in the bottom and select another user from the list. Step 5. Lastly, please click on Logout icon for exit or logout. It may be noted that the patient can exit the app without logging out. In this case, no further OTP is required when the app is opened next time. But if the user logs out, then the fresh OTP is required for login, and the OTP will come on the registered mobile number attached to CR number or UMID number. Now we will come to the part 2 of the video. Here we will explain the teleconsultation process in following 7 simple steps. 1. How patient can raise teleconsultation request. 2. How to select the user, hospital and department unit. 3. How to fill basic details and health issues. 4. How to select the slot for consultation. 5. How to see the status of request raised. 6. How the consultation is done with the doctor. 7. How to view and download prescription from the app. Now let us see them step by step. Step 1 is about how to raise teleconsultation request. User can raise a new teleconsultation request by clicking on the teleconsultancy request option. Step 2 is about selecting user, hospital and department unit. First, user can choose any one of the user attached to the common mobile number in a family. Then, hospital in which the user wishes to raise the request can be selected from the drop-down options. Normally, the requests are to be raised only in the registered hospital. Otherwise, the request may or may not be considered depending on feasibility and priority for the doctor of that specific hospital. Then department unit or specialty in which the consultation is required has to be selected. Please note that only those specialties which will be visible which are available in the hospital for teleconsultation. Step 3 is about how to fill basic details and health issues. Patient can fill basic details like height and weight, medical details like symptoms, current medication, history of current illness, known allergies, etc. have to be filled. Problem can be described in 500 words. Step 4, slot selection. User can choose the date on which the consultation is desired as per the available slots. It will show the number of slots available for finalization of the request. Up to 3 image files related to the problem like lab reports or previous prescriptions, etc. can also be uploaded, and then click on done. Step 5, confirmation of slot. Now the allotted time of consultation will be conveyed to the patient after approval of the request by the concerned doctor. There is also a chart feature by which messages can be given by doctor as well as patient. Step 6. Request status. Patient can see the status of request raised for consultations. It will show as either pending or approved. Step 7 is about consultation with the doctor. Normally, the doctor initiates the call with the built-in video or audio conference facility, and the patient will be able to see the incoming video call for the consultation. By accepting the call, patient will be able to consult the doctor through video conference. Step 8 is about prescription. After ending or during the call, doctor will be able to record all the observations made during the consultation, and patient will be able to view and download the prescription by clicking on View Prescription. Prescription will contain details filled by the doctor about drugs, investigations, etc., which can be used in the pharmacy or labs for further process. Finally, please note that initially this app will be independent of HMIS patient app. Later on, this app will be merged with the HMIS main app. We will notify when it is done. This is all about the teleconsultation process for patients. Thank you.